Hey guys, welcome to the Junior Astrophysicist. This is Akash, and in this video we're going to be looking at photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect is a great topic to study while learning quantum physics, so let's begin. So photoelectric effect was proposed by Albert Einstein. What is the photoelectric effect? So this theory of photoelectric effect describes the relationship between electrons at a metal surface and light. The great theoretical physicist Albert Einstein, who was the founder of the theory of relativity, and he was renowned for that topic, and he had also received Nobel Prize on his observation and founding of photoelectric effect. This is Albert Einstein, the great theoretical physicist. The photoelectric effect states that when an electromagnetic wave or radiation is striking the surface of metal, it can be any metal, it can be zinc, or it can be copper, or it can be anything. The electrons are ejected or emitted from the surface of the metal. So what happens is a wave or radiation strikes the metal and electrons are ejected. So these ejected electrons are called photoelectrons. Now, if this is a metal and these are the electrons on the surface of the metal, and now we're going to strike some electromagnetic radiation or wave at it and electrons are ejected. So this is what photoelectric effect basically states. Now we shall move into detail about this topic. The properties are how it takes place. The number of photoelectrons and its kinetic energy depends on the intensity of the electromagnetic radiation. So an electromagnetic radiation has its own intensity or its own strength. So what happens is when the intensity of the electromagnetic radiation is higher, the number of photoelectrons emitted and the energy of the photoelectrons are also going to be high. And when the wave with a higher intensity has a lower wavelength, this means that the higher the energy, lower the wavelength. This is the visible light region of the electromagnetic spectrum. So ultraviolet has the least intensity and infrared has the highest intensity. What you can see in the middle is called visible light. When the wavelength is lower and the frequency is higher, the radiation becomes higher. So what happens is that when it strikes the surface of the metal, more photoelectrons are ejected and they have a higher kinetic energy. Or vice versa. It's the same thing in the opposite way. When you strike the surface of a metal, less number of electrons are emitted and the electrons have a lower energy. So when the frequency of the wave is high, the number of photoelectrons and its energy is higher. So when the frequency is higher, the wavelength is lower. In the first image, you can see that there's a very low frequency and a higher wavelength and no electrons are ejected or emitted from it. So there are zero photoelectrons. In the second, you can see that there's a higher frequency but lower wavelength, slightly lower than the first one, but you have a few electrons with a low energy. And in the third one, you can see that the frequency is high and wavelength is very low compared to the other two, and you're having more electrons with a higher energy. Laws of photoelectric effect. So most theories, or practically every theory, has its own laws. Now, we shall look at the laws of photoelectric effect. The number of photoelectrons is directly proportional to the intensity of the incident radiation. Incident radiation is the electromagnetic wave or radiation with firing at the metal surface. So what happens? The number of photoelectrons ejected. So if we're having around 3 photoelectrons, then intensity of the incident radiation is 3 nm. For any metal, there's a certain frequency below which photoelectric emission doesn't take place. This frequency is called threshold frequency. So for any reaction or process to happen, there's a certain point. Only above that point, you have something happening. So it's the same with photoelectric effect. Only when the intensity reaches, or the frequency of the wave reaches the threshold frequency, photoelectrons or electrons are going to be emitted from the metal surface. If it doesn't reach the threshold frequency, there's going to be no process, nothing happening. When the frequency of the radiation wave is higher than the threshold frequency, that's what usually happens when electrons are ejected. It doesn't depend on the intensity of the electromagnetic wave or radiation, the strength, but it depends on the wavelength and frequency. That is because intensity is only the strength. It doesn't determine the wave. This process takes place very quickly. The time lag, like now when the wave strikes, the time lag between it striking and the electron ejecting is only 10 to the power of minus 9 seconds, which is a very teeny, 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 teeny time amount. Current and intensity of light. So what does current have to do with intensity of light? Well, when the intensity of light is high, the energy of electrons is high. So that results in a higher current. If the intensity is lower, then the current produced will also be less. Makes sense. A graph states this. Now we're having a certain level of intensity over there and the current is high. So you can also see that the intensity is high and the current is high. So that is about the current and intensity of light. Now let's work with the simulator. So this simulation was made possible by FET simulation. So let's begin using a simulator and let's do it on our own. The link for the simulation is available in the description box below my title. So let's begin with it. Now, this metal is a sodium metal that is described here as the target. Now let's increase the intensity of light. We're placing the intensity at 100%, and now we're gonna be increasing the energy or intensity using the color. So now infrared has the highest wavelength and ultraviolet has the least wavelength and the higher frequency. So there's a possibility of more free electrons being emitted when we reach ultraviolet. So let's verify it using this simulation. So you can see there are no electrons till now. We're already at 680 nanometers. Yes, let's go. Using the simulator, we can also measure the threshold frequency. Okay, so around 500 nanometers. So around 500 nanometers, the first electron started to come out. So the threshold frequency is 500 nanometers when your intensity is very high. For sodium. Now let's try zinc. So while studying chemistry, you might have all learned about something called the reactivity series. See, in the reactivity table, the most reactive is at the top and the least reactive is at the bottom. So the most reactive has more electrons coming out even when the energy is less, which means higher the reactivity, higher the electrons in the aerosol and higher coming out, okay? So now zinc is a bit less reactive than sodium, so we need more energy. Let's go up. Yes. Still no sign of electrons. Yes, around 240 nanometers. Well, calcium is more reactive than zinc, but less reactive than sodium. So we're already having stuff coming up, electrons. So for calcium, it's around 400 nanometers. And that's how we work it out using this simulator. You can also measure the current over here. Now, there are also graphs like current versus battery voltage, current versus light intensity, electron energy versus light frequency. First, let's just work with these two graphs. We don't need that graph for now. Current versus light intensity, you can see the graph over here. Let me just place sodium, that would be the best option. Intensity is high, everything is high. Just look at the graph. With the intensity, the current is increasing. You see the graph? You will understand that. Now, electron energy versus light frequency. So as we discussed, when the frequency is higher, the energy is going to be higher. So I'm increasing the frequency, the energy is increasing. We have verified everything using this. You can try this simulation when you're free using the link in the description, as I already mentioned. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Subscribe to the Junior Asset Physics, like, and also share. And I'll be back with more fun videos soon. Bye, guys. Have fun learning.